Yo. What's going on, guys? Ladies and gents. Hey. So this is cool. I was lucky enough to get my hands on a second monitor. Just hide a video preview real quick. So I don't have to look at my my sad dinky little phone anymore to read the chat, so that's pretty neat. Looks like the stream quality is still kinda all over the place. Hopefully that evens out. Yeah, we'll see. But yeah, this means if I'm looking over here like that, it means I'm looking at chat stuff. If there's chat stuff happening, so it's pretty cool. But yeah, tonight, gonna be working on something a little bit different. Had a request from my good friend Kevin. We have birthdays really close to each other. And I've been borrowing some Berserk comics from him. Stuff like this, starring the ever-violent Guts. And he said, I know what I want for my birthday. I want a drawing of Guts. So I told him I'd do that. And that's what we're going to work on tonight. And hopefully he'll arrive at some point so he can let me know if it's living up to his expectations or not. Hanging out in the basement, comfortable. Got sweatpants on. Feeling pretty good about that. Size something. Let's start off at 8.5 by 11. 8.5 by 7.77 while we're sketching. Hey birthday boy. Two days belated birthday boy. Are you ready for a cool drawing? Yeah, Kevin, let me know if the stream quality is kind of shady. I don't have a ton of stuff open, but it is giving me like some dropped frames warning. I'm not doing any music streaming today, so it might just be between this and Netflix upstairs. We're a little bit, internet's getting a little tired, but we'll see. Hopefully it doesn't drop out too much, because I don't know what I can do to fix it. But I might put a little bit more on this, ask the stuff to do a little bit more work, because, I don't know, man. I want to maybe do chronolapse of this guy. What can I do that would be fixing our quality a little bit? But yeah, the second monitor is awesome. It's like almost a perfect square, tiny little baby monitor, and it has. It was cool. I've never actually seen a monitor with like hot pixels or like misfiring pixels, and it had a couple. It was pretty cool. What can we do to fix this? It is hooked up, and I'm looking up that instead of. Actually, what am I doing? Stop this. Sorry, I'm just kind of fumbling for a minute. I was gonna do I was going to set up Chronolapse, but then I just realized I'm recording a video of this anyway, so I can just speed that up. Post if I really wanted to. Yeah, let me burp all over the place. Actually, I'm going to move my file stuff off to the side, so I don't have to keep showing everybody my goofy file structure. Just trying to think of a place to save this. Oh! And it's not 2015 anymore. I'm just going to put it in my 2015 folder for now. That. I can't stop living in the past. It's so cool. Didn't they invent the hoverboard last year because of what's its face? Oh, there we go. I've got the tray all gone. I just need a more neutral gray so my eyes don't bug out. So yeah, this is cool. You thought you were getting Guts, but I'm just going to draw Puck for 2 hours. It is a little different. I took away the piece of paper over there, and I put a different light bulb up there. It's still not perfect. But I was doing it. And it seems that if I had the sheet of paper away and a different light bulb, the green behind me is a little more even. I see Puck always has his butt out like that. There you go. Happy birthday, Kevin. Happy birthday. Your favorite little elf. No, it was really funny. I was talking to I was thinking more about. All right, now let's do this for real. I was thinking more about Puck's role in the first couple books, and oh yeah, there's some really good, like, insane Guts in volume 3. But you're kind of like, what is this, like, naked flying little boy without any genitalia doing, and why is he, like, doing all these kind of, like, gag reel stuff? But he's, like, kind of necessary, just for all of the insane, like, demon and devil stuff that's going on. I feel like it would just be, like, a really hard beginning to a book like this without having that in there. Yeah, insane Guts. That's what I figured. I'm glad all that stuff kind of happens early on, too. We've got, like, Guts falling down. He's already missing an eye. He's, like, stabbing the snail thing in the head. I'm looking through the pages right now. I'm like, ha ha ha, ha. It's so cool. I wish I had a little book stand. Or I wish I had a tiny little... Wish I had a tiny little elf named Puck to hold the book open for me. It's really weird that they would edit him out, I guess. Hang on. I think I'm gonna use this handy Nalgene bottle as my surrogate Puck. First I'm gonna take a drink, and then I'm gonna spill water on Kevin's book. this naked little Nalgene. I'm gonna pretend I've got a little, pixie boy in there. Drop some crap on my desk, make a loud sound. Man, what I really need is I really need two little Nalgenes to prop this open. Cause I don't wanna have a reference image up on Google, because then I won't be able to read chat stuff. This is okay. I'm gonna have to wing it a little bit, because I'm not like a guts master. Whoa, opacity 10%. Go to hell. I'm not even sure what's in that. Altoids tin. So Kevin, how large of a thing do you want? How large of a drawing? This is, right now I'm sketching this at 8.5 by 11. Could definitely, I'm just gonna do really rough stuff and then can switch it up. Jerom BD, yeah. Berserk is pretty good. I'm just farting around for a minute until I get something. I was feeling like 8.5 by 11. If I do something not full body, like something more of like a bust, we can get more gnarly detail. Close-upishness. Yeah, frameable guts. How's the mic volume compared to music volume, by the way? Nobody is like screamed out in pain. I don't care about his feet. Too bad, because here they are. Woo-hoo-hoo. Good. Here's those little tiny feet. Yeah, the hand cannon is pretty good. Give me them feet. Guts, feet. Can't have nothing but the feet. Still looks like we're dropping frames. Might just have to leave with it. Leave with it. Live with it. Yeah, hopefully it's not too garbage. This is peak internet hours, man. This is when everybody and their mother is using the internet. Seems okay. Alright, well, hopefully it stays okay. By my readings on my side, it still says it's dropping. Dropping like it's hot drops. What has he got in this scene? It's kind of a buffet scene where he's like standing up and there's blood spitting out of his neck. Man, it's so crazy. You know, just him getting like splatted everywhere. Should have picked a couple good reference shots beforehand, but nobody's perfect, dog. Well, good. I'm glad my side says it's dropping frames, and that may not actually be the truth. The truth side. What does that cannon arm look like? This is gonna be 2 hours of me just reading comics and saying, "Whoa, wow, sick, guts is awesome." back over the Altoids tin again. Dang it, Bobby. I might just have to hold the book in my left hand. I haven't watched that show in quite the time. It's been a while. Look at this. I've got two Berserk books down here I can take a look at. All the reference I can dream of. Yeah, I suppose I should just look at him before he gets totally destroyed. Less of a mental leap. That's great. What am I doing? What am I messing around with this bad page for? Yoink. Ooh, that junk. That crummy book. Is this the book market? We got this figured out. Look at this. This process. Trying to get a piece of paper out from here. Hey dude, thanks. Yeah, my birthday is in 3 hours ish. I think I was born in like early morning on the 12th, so it's a birthday stream for a birthday boy. My birthday boy. Damn, goofy text is gonna ruin my mind. Whoops. Yeah, getting older. C'est la vie. Such is the life. He's got that spiky hair like a punk. Action. Man, this fight scene in the stairwell was insane. Right, he's got those really distinctive pauldrons. Rum Rusher. What's up, dude? What's cooking? I know, I love it though. Whoops. Alright. One-handed Photoshop. It's not recommended. It should just go as crazy. Looks, you know, I don't even need color palette right now. More canvas for the time being. Can always come back. Oh, I see what's getting. Right, this might be tricky. It might be fine. I just realized that my tablet is mapped to both this side of the monitor and that side of the monitor. Won't be an issue if I just don't try to draw too fast. But I just realized it now. I feel like I've been doing this kind of thing long enough that that's not gonna freak my mind out. We'll see. We will see. What does he have going on with this chest piece thing? Yeah, don't draw too fast, but don't draw too slow. That's exactly my mindset right now. You can draw too fast. Getting serenaded. What a birthday. What a birthday present. Oh my gosh. I feel like a kid in like a 90s ad, like reading comics, like, holy crap, can you believe what they did on that page? Can you believe that? Oh my god, I'm blown away. My mind is getting destroyed. It's great, he's got a handful of little bits and bobs. A furry version of Guts? Okay. What do you do? What if Guts and Puck had a baby? Yeah, I'm just reading comics. Reading comics on the internet. It's pretty cool. Or I should say, manga. Manga comics. There's a good view of this weirdo belt codpiece thing. Guts. What a dude. He's got a giant ass. Blade. Crazy blade. Crazy blade for days. I'm kind of digging the bandaged eye Guts, specifically from page 165, volume 2. That's pretty sweet. Maybe we'll do that. I don't know if we want to have him like looking determined or looking just totally insane. What do you think, sir? Because if we're doing totally insane, I probably just want to change up his pose a little bit. Bandaged eye Guts. That's great. Good Guts.
like insane.
You're doing insane. He's got an eyeball out.
His eyeball sticking out. Compassionate Guts. Crazy Guts. Angry Guts. Where is he? It's Happy Guts. Putting on airs. Bookmark this page. I feel like it almost wants to be like a full page image, just this crazy face. Hang on, this might sound bad. I'm fiddling with the old helper Nalgene. Trying to jury rig a little setup. Ooh la la. That doesn't work at all. Yeah, just peeking. So yeah, this is just sketching, and then we'll do like a essentially like an ink on top of this. The two rows of teeth that don't meet, smiling, eye wide open. At least for a crazy man face. That sounds great. I want to draw him serving a piece of birthday cake to a Behelit. And the birthday cake is going to be crying, or the Behelit is going to be crying. Yeah, that totally got my brain going. That was just awesome how they did that. Super insane. Winking at the camera. Yeah. Best laid plans of mice and men. Get all crazy. Yeah, the God Hand. I got a little glimpse of that. That was pretty good. Yeah, dude, thank you for Mr. Rum, thank you for all the cool Grizzled Dude drawings over the past couple months. That has been a sick thing to see, just like out of the blue. I do want to go back and do some more Grizzled Dude stories sometime. I'm not sure when. I have some written, but then, you know, it's like, the more I wait, the more stuff changes. Friggin' cougar. Getting that finger bath going. I tell you, as soon as I finish up the stream, I'm gonna bust out those barbecue chips. And man, then it's on. It's game time. Guts. Gus. Check it. Look at Gus. I'm drawing Gus. Check out this Gus. I'm glad I put this on its own layer. Boom. Can't be bargained with, it can't be reasoned with. That's like working with Kevin on this stinking drawing. Get all of our elements in place, boom, ba, boom. Guts has gone crazy. Rotate the whole thing so it doesn't look like he's taking a squat. Time to start drawing the water for that chip dust finger bath. This means his whole Paul drone needs to be elevated more. What's going on, Cougs? What's shaking? What's shaking in the world of ASMR snack research? Coug dog. Coogan. I'm just gonna keep saying your name in funny ways until the chat catches up with me. The Coogler. Coogerator. That's pretty good. Coog it or lose it. Soaking it all in. Give it a shot. I thought I had links disabled to people, but I think they might be enabled, even though I went and checked afterwards and verified that they are indeed disabled. Twitch got some explaining to do. So yeah, man, give it a post. Worst thing that happens is you get banned for life. Just kidding. I wouldn't do that. Deleted link testing. Huh. Hang on one second. Let me open up the old tweeter. I get to do this all off screen now because I have a web browser open. That's sick. Got it, man. What is this? Look at that. Come on, Twitter, don't be stingy. I'm trying to Copy link to tweet. Yes, please. Copy link of tweet to easily share it with your friends, like my friends on Twitch. I got it. Here it comes. Oh, thanks, dude. That's super fun. All right, back to the task at hand. A very serious birthday. Birthday arts. Yeah, I don't know about this little hand here. It looks kind of like he's gonna bonk himself on the head, like one of the Three Stooges. Ooh. Yeah, isn't that thing terrifying? That Behelit gif. Love that thing. It's so freaking crazy. They really got some crazy, crazy ass pathos going on. It hurts me to look at. Yeah, I can imagine. I've already been like, holy crap, shaking the book around and getting all jazzed up. Can only imagine where it's gonna go. Jeez. I can't wait for that. Very good. Feel comfortable with this rotation angle again. Later, Cougs. Peace out, dude. I'll be thinking of you every time I hear a wet whisper or a mouth sound. Or anytime I see a horse peeking around a wall. I'll be thinking of you. I do think it's like trademark Guts hairdo of like the, it goes up and then it goes down. It's pretty fun. Sexy nay. Kawaii nay. Something a cute horse would say. Kawaii nay. Syriac, did you mean Syrian? Man, I can type in the chat now, it's so easy.
Oh.
This is a wee little game changer. If I do say so myself. Scrooge. Cougar's a good dude. Copy and pasting. Yeah, I really like that. Again, that was like some of the comic relief, where the Behelit is having a little episode because it can't deal with Puck. It's like so embarrassed. God, do I really have to be toted around by an elf right now? Cougar's a good dude. He's a working man. That's nice. Pop upstairs in a minute just to make sure the cats aren't going insane. Because they might be. These cats are wont to do. It's like the witching hour for cats. And read more. Sorry, guys. Stream's over. I gotta read some comics. Cruising around our, we've got like a little mudroom in the back where we keep the recycling, and I think I saw a little itty bitty little mousey jump around back there when I was throwing something out. So that might be part of what's going on. If it is, hope the cats are up to the task. I've been dreaming of an opportunity like this. So yeah, what are people up to these days? Playing any good video games? Having any good pickups? Pickups like me? See any decent movies? We just rented the last most recent Planet of the Apes movie from the library, and that was really excellent. And then working. Everybody's working for the weekend. They're pretty good. I dug them. I like that. I like that, the new angle, the new direction of the Planet of the Apes stuff. Oof. Neck twisty. Ouch. Blues Brothers. I can't say I've ever even seen that. I've seen clips. Yeah, I mean, it's got some of the, like, the original greats in it. This is cool. Now I know where Guts got that nose scar from. Pray Cabbage, what's up? What's cooking? Do some looking. Man, this dude's got some convoluted lights and darks in his head. It's gonna take a couple. Some back and forth, and at least Blue's Clues. For the first time, finally, getting your Blue's Clues on. Thanks, man. I hope it's good enough. He looks a little bit like a child still, but once we get some spot blacks in here, that will help. I'm trying not to. I don't want to over focus one area. I'm using the Intuos 4 tablet. Got my dual monitor set up now. I haven't done any checking. The width of it is mapped to both monitors, which is a little bit disorienting, but maybe not even that disorienting. I might just be imagining it. Like a made up thing. I feel like as long as I'm paying attention to what I'm drawing, it's not so bad. Yeah, it's got a little bit of that. I used to have some of that stuff in MP3s, some of the Evangelist stuff. It's been a long time since I listened to it. I probably still do have it. That and the Akira soundtrack has some really good stuff going on in it. Golden Age Arc movies. Is that so polyneutral? I think there was one like 1 hour thing they had on Netflix a little while ago, and it might have been the first one of that. I really, really dug it. Yeah, I'm doing this guts drawing for Mr. Cablasto here. It was his birthday 2 days ago. And he got me into... Yeah, that's awesome. He got me into... got me into Berserk. He gave me the first book. Then I saw that thing on Netflix, and I was like, this is cool. This is not where I left off, but it's cool. I'll check it out. And then... Now he's lending me the other books, and it's I think I'm just like 3 volumes in so far, but it's super excellent. Yeah, Prey Cabbage. I use a Cintiq at work, and it's good, but I'm not like so tied to working exclusively on that. And I mean, my home setup is fine. Everything works. It's a lot cheaper to maintain. If I had like $1,000 or $2,000 to burn, which is like kind of unlikely, I might consider it. But at the same time, one of the things I like a lot about working on a tablet and not working on a Cintiq is, so when you're using a Cintiq, or like a draw on screen, your hand is in the way. Like I can't actually see what I'm, you know, I don't have a transparent hand, as like dumb as that sounds. But I like having, I like the hand-eye separation of working on a tablet. I know I've mentioned it a couple times before, but I like being able to kind of see everything in my own body isn't an obstacle to me being able to interpret what's going on. But they're nice, you know. A Cintiq is an awesome tool. Polyneutral, thanks, man. Halloween Forever is coming to Steam. I'm trying to debug. I'm having some honest to goodness newbie build submission issues where I have a up until tonight I was posting a build that was like 0 out of 0 bytes, and I couldn't figure out why until tonight, and the game wouldn't launch in my test view, and I was able to get actual files uploaded and have it register as there's actual file in there, but it still won't launch properly. So I just need, you know, take some time to sit down and mess around with that a bit. But I mean, if you already bought it on itch.io, which is super awesome, I really appreciate that. I want to make sure that everybody on itch gets a Steam key. So it might take a minute. I think I might be able to do it in an automated way once everything is up and hosted. But it is coming soon. So much, much, much appreciated. I don't know if I've seen you in the chat on like some previous streams, but I have been working on some new content add-ons for it, just because I felt like with it going to Steam, it would be nice to, you know, throw a little bit of extra on there. So probably some new levels and maybe some menu stuff. I haven't been able to spend a ton of time on the dev side of things just because I'm really trying to get it just submitted first in a playable state. Nasal130, thanks, man. I gotta get it playable and testable before I really start digging into the content. But all that stuff is ideally coming. It might just be a minute. But if you enjoyed Halloween Forever, there's some more to come. But yeah, very cool also to hear that you are starting off with some game dev too. It's very fun. Super fun to be able to see a project to completion. Yeah, and as much as I want to add to Halloween Forever stuff, I want to start a new game too. I've got a couple things in mind that would be fun to do. Nazo, I'm working on this thing called Halloween Forever. If you guys are looking at the chat or the Twitch view, you just scroll down and there's should be a link to it. I've got it hosted over on itch.io right now. Just look for the little pumpkin man action. Yeah, dude, I will check it out for sure. I have been putting I've been putting the archives onto YouTube. Just Let me just do an internet thing real quick and I can send you guys a link. It's happening. Oh, it's confusing what WordPress does on a tiny page. And I've got the window real small. In case you guys want to zip through, I don't know. I don't really know how interesting it is to like watch an old stream, like when the chat is expired. But feel free to, you know, take a look if you guys want to scope any of the stuff out. Zip around and glean some pixel art process stuff. Could be fun. Do I have any improvements for drawings? Do you mean like, do I have any recommendations for improving? Guts is like 100% black, essentially. I'm just going to do really rough lines and then start doing some spots on a different layer. Man. Well, I think, so I don't do any editing. I have, at least as far as Twitch stuff, what I'll do is I have it recording locally as an FLV through OBS, you know, in case I ever need it. I'm not really sure if I'm ever going to, and I might even start deleting some of those soon. But after that, I just have that export from Twitch right to YouTube without just spit it right out. So right now I'm trying to stream Monday nights and Tuesday nights. I may not stream tomorrow night because it's my birthday. If anything, I'll hang out and do not something that is totally work related. Like maybe actually play a game. But we'll have to see how that goes. Oh, even this little curly wire. But yeah, dude, Nazo, a lot of it is just practice, you know. There's a lot of things you can do, you know, a lot of good ways you can kind of practice and do studies. Like, honestly, like, copying, like, looking at actual, like, anatomy books and copying stuff from the literal book, so to speak, is a decent way to just to get some fundamentals. I still do that from time to time. There's a handful of things. I do sell my work, too. I have a shop on imaginarymonsters.com. It's not totally up to date. I'm in the process of sort of moving things over from what was on my Etsy account forever to there, and I have to, you know, re-inventory shirts and stuff and just keep track, like, remember what exactly I have. But I have a lot of old screen prints and things, and some shirts, some designs are newer than others. Yeah, I haven't done a printed book of my own stuff in a while, or any like mini comics, but I want to. You know, I'm starting to get that itch. Especially doing stuff like this. Gets me thinking more about like, oh, what if I did some of this with my time? But I think one of the most appealing things about the possibility of doing games just from like a fulfillment sense is it's so accessible compared to, you know, if I sell something or if I have a printed book and somebody buys a copy and then I'm on the hook to, you know, send them a copy, quantity can be pretty limited. It's just so nice having a game available online and not having to worry about like, oh cool, somebody wanted to pick it up, cool, $3, PayPal does all the work and they can instantly download a thing, and you still get, you know, that sense of connection, like, whoa, somebody made this cool thing and I can mess around with it and we can talk a little bit online and all that sort of stuff. Yeah, Nuclear Throne is awesome, and actually, like, we've talked about it a lot recently. I love all the stuff that Vlambeer does, and I think I consciously or subconsciously was avoiding playing Nuclear and Throne while I was working on Death State, because I'm glad that I did avoid it, because just in playing it, it's the sort of thing where you see some work that may be close to some work that you're doing, and you don't, at least I get into this kind of mindset where I don't always want to, you know, immerse myself in things that might be similar to something that I'm doing, because I don't want to let that lead my design process or thought process entirely, even, you know, accidentally. There's like a degree of, this is cool, this is contemporary, I want to be aware of this, versus just let me kind of, you know, exist in sort of like an imaginary vacuum a little bit. And, you know, I was working on it, like, a lot of people worked on Death State, and especially, you know, Matt was he's like other co-creator, lead dev on it. We spent a lot of time talking about, you know, what we liked and what we didn't like, or what we wanted to do with our blend of mechanics that we maybe did see or maybe didn't see in other games. So it's hard. I feel like it's risky too, because you could just do something and saying, you know, I don't want to be influenced by other people's things, I'm just going to do my own thing, and then you wind up doing something that is just derivative because something has been done before in too similar a fashion, and, you know, it's kind of your responsibility to know what other people had done to a degree, so that, you know, you weren't doing like some accident of parallel development and wound up being derivative in that regard. So it's tricky, but I think we had enough people playtesting Death State in the office and, you know, spending time with the game that they were, you know, aware of things and, you know, bringing up certain points. But I love it. It's really fun. The Vlambeer guys do a really good job of hitting, at least for me, hitting the right amount of, you know, kind of weird feedback and fun, and just, and I'm interested to see how much of it has lasting quality or staying quality if I were to play the game a lot. So, you know, how much of like the weird monster screams and things gets old versus like, this is great, I want to spend, you know, another 10 hours messing around with this. Let's see what's going on. Looking at the reference. Yeah, Nazo, it's hard to say one thing. I have, you know, shirts I usually sell for like 20 or so. I have some screen prints. I think they're on my website, and those are usually, you know, anywhere between 20 and 30. But original stuff, I definitely would do, you know, more than that. Yeah, man, Dagon. I figure he's got like a handful of crazy knives down here. What am I looking at? Yeah, I'm starting to talk to some people about maybe beginning to carry some more of my shirts in stores in town or locally, and I might actually wind up charging a little bit more for shirts in the future, but we'll see. Horrible podcast, what's up, man? Yeah, I'm excited to see that. I'm just getting into Berserk right now, essentially. Reading the comics, and you know, really digging just the insanity of it. NBC doing an anime? That sounds crazy. That's crazy talk. Get out of here. I know what I'm doing on my birthday. I'm gonna watch some anime on NBC. So crazy, of all the things to produce, it must be some like weird branch thing, like NBC's version of Miramax. Tune. Special priced Blu-ray set on April 20th. Nice. We should get that and watch it. I would pick that up and marathon some Zerk. I mean, if there's like so many volumes of the book, how many episodes are there of the adaptation? Box of War. I mean, honestly, if the guy's been making 30 plus volumes of the stinking book, take a vacation, man. 34 as of the printing of that thing. It's insane. Interesting. Huh. Poor bastard. I mean, how old is he to be making insano, violent demon comics like this? This is how the rumor mill gets started. He's got this funny pants thing. Oh man. This is it right here. I don't know if you guys can see it. That is like my favorite panel, which is like the insane count in the shadow. I just wanted to draw you that, Kevin. Scrap everything else and just draw that over and over and over again. Ugh. Crazy ass glowing eyes. Just look how cool that is. 49. Honestly, if you were 40, if your life is making comics, like your back is bent over a drafting table all day. Working on tiny details. I'm surprised these dudes live that long. It's not kind work to your body. It's not a generous. Computer stuff isn't that much better, I guess. Left-handed. Guess it beats manual labor, though. I don't know. All work is gonna kill you, so just enjoy it. Wow. It's so good. I'm doing one book for this long. Okay, I see how this works. I see how it works. Busy people, man. Busy people never really stop working. It's kind of crazy. He's got, what is that on his little belt? Look at that! Look at that cool shit. He's got the little Syracuse S. Everybody used to draw that in grade school. Have to make that bigger. Yeah, do you guys remember this? This cool thing that everybody used to write. Well, Guts has got one on his belt. How sweet is that? He'd be so cool in grade school. like giant barbarian walks in to science class, like a 10-foot sword sticking out of his back and knives all over him, more belts than he knows what to do with, and everybody just looks at him and says, "Oh, where did you get that cool S belt? Oh my god, that S belt is so cool. I want an S belt like that." Yeah, I mean, if he's been doing Berserk since the 80s, it's long enough. Could have invented it. The craze, the founder of the sickest craze that's sweeping the teens of the nation. How did you draw that S? And everybody like claims ownership of it too. Like, we used to call it, it was like the Syracuse S, because apparently it was invented in Syracuse and it's an S, right? Sounds good. Sounds real good. Just gonna have to watch it undubbed. You have to watch that dubbed version. And that Goku guts. Look at that crazy crotch. Yeah, it was the Vegas S, because of the S in Vegas, right? Everybody's drawing that S. It's the craze. It's the craze that's sweeping the nation. I feel like a real tit. Did you not draw that S when you were a kid? I'm telling you, man. Everybody was doing it back then. How are we doing on time? 10:30. Oh! That's the Siebert S. Bam! Your family crest. Super S. Dubs, redubs. Alright, we gotta get some dark darks in this soon. Start blocking some things out. Debunked. The myth was debunked. Goku.
Gotta keep your anime voice heroes straight. It's hard to keep them all straight. How's that look? He's got this cool little Scrimshaw belt buckle. Sorry guys, you can be a dubbing connoisseur. I'm not gonna judge you. I mean, I think they had all English voices in the Golden Age anime that they had on Netflix. I might have been trying to look for subtitled version when I was watching it, and I just was like, all right, it's Berserk, I'm gonna give it a shot. I just ran with it, and it was decent. They did a good job. You play as a backpack. That sounds cool, dude. It's like you could have like a game about mimics where you play as the mimic, and it's like a stealth game. The music I'm playing isn't really royalty-free. I'm just doing, I have a playlist that's mostly stuff by Perturbator, that usually doesn't get flagged with, Digital Millennium copyright stuff. I haven't really spent a lot of time looking for royalty-free playlist stuff. Anything that I'm putting on YouTube, I'm not marking as monetize it, so I'm not concerned if I get something muted or flagged on YouTube because I'm not claiming full ownership of it. Eventually I might look for royalty-free music to have in a stream, but just right now I want to listen to stuff that I want to listen to, not music that is kosher because the internet lords have deemed it so. Yeah, it sucked. I had this like really, I think the first stream I ever did, I got so excited and I was listening to, I was having a great time and was listening to Black Sabbath, and then I just got slapped with all these like annoying alerts and messages when I put my stuff onto YouTube, and I was like, damn it, you know. I understand that Ozzy owns this music, but I own my voice, and I was speaking, and I got all muted and stuff, and that was irritating. But, you know, worse things could happen. Little pauldrons bit over here going.
Let me see. Pray Cabbage, if you DM me the link, I can, or maybe if you whisper it to me, I could send it to you, or you could tweet it at me. Might be the easier way. I'll repost it for you. I gotcha, buddy. Oh, is it my YouTube? Sorry, eek. This? It's dumb that it's user slash but I'm a wizard. I tried switching it to Imaginary Monsters, and apparently YouTube lets you rename your channel ID, but only if you have like a shit ton of subscribers. Like, they want you to have, I think, 1,000 subscribers or something. So, but I'm a Wizard is an old account that I used to use until I started switching everything over to my name or Imaginary Monsters. But it's okay. I got most of them, mostly current. I tried real hard to be a cool current internet kid. What are those knives do? What are we looking at? Hoo-wee! Yeah, it's tough. This is the kind of thing that I feel like would... I don't do a ton of digital inking, and I know I could do it quicker slash better, maybe more interestingly on paper, but I also lose the ability to share it with y'alls and talk about it and hang out and do a little streambo. Maybe someday I will get some subs. I do, it's, so, I mean, YouTube is awesome, and I enjoy putting stream archive stuff on there, but I do want to put more original stuff, like the time-lapse drawings. Those would be fun. No, Horrible Podcast, I really like your guys' channel. You guys do some fun coverage on stuff, and it's just like hanging out too, which is nice. It makes me want to like fire up your channel and just like open up a beer and just chill. I think that's a good thing. You guys are like the YouTube and chill channel. That's what people are calling it. You want to come over for a little podcast and chill? Little YouTube and chill. Come on, keyboard shortcuts, what are you doing? I'm getting angry. Damn it. Anyway. I can't do this on paper. Ha ha ha. Digital art.
digital.
Fooled you. You thought I drew every detail. Suckers. Joke's on you, Kevin. Enjoy your crappy birthday present. No, that's all right, dude. Honestly, we have like some very polarized opinions about Death State difficulty in the office, where we have people that are playing it and they're like, vanilla game, no desecration, difficulty is trivial. But then, you know, sometimes then like the co-creators still can't get like a good run going, and they still have you know, like a hard time just going through the main game, which is good. Honestly, it's good for people, I think, to, you know, run with the game and say like, this is great, or this is easier, or look at this crazy run that I did. It's just challenging when you have one game that you're trying to suit many different kind of play styles and many different levels of, I guess, just like expertise at playing games and, you know, skill levels, where it's kind of it's the kind of thing where like sometimes, you know, somebody who's like a hardcore, we've had comments where people that are like hardcore bullet hell players are like, oh my god, this casual game, or we've watched people, you know, pick up the game, stream it on Twitch and clear it in like their first two or three sittings in like 40 minutes, and they're like, is that it? And to them we're like, try turning up the difficulty a little bit. And then also we have a ton of people yet who haven't, you know, like beaten it. They bought it and they just haven't cleared it yet. So it goes both ways. It's interesting, man. 1.13. I'm trying to think. That was that the one we put out today? Or We've got an update coming soon. Might be a little secret spoily. 1.13. I'm trying to think of what went on in there. That wasn't the big content patch. 1.1 had tons of the new levels and stuff. But I know we're adding some new things, like some stuff that'll be pretty useful. Like we have we're adding in a toggle for visible hitbox. A couple people have asked for that, and we felt like it was pretty decent. Oh, sick. Yeah, good, dude. So you can see the visible hitbox. Visible hitbox. If you want it. It's a little bit power gamey, but I think honestly probably ideal for the way some people want to play their Death State. Gotta start filling some stuff. Yeah, and honestly, you know, it's the kind of thing. It's been on our like internal to-do list and wish list for a long time, but we just other features were higher priority, didn't get around to it yet. But it's one of those like good reminders where people are saying, you know, hey, I want you to add a little bit of hitbox. We're saying, yeah, that hitbox thing, whatever came of that, let's pop it in and see how it goes. And it winds up being, you know, something that was easy to implement, something that visualizes pretty nicely, and works out okay. I think it's a helpful little feature. Dude, I'm glad you're enjoying this, because it's your drawing. You gotta live with it. Fudging his pauldrons a little bit. Just because the angle is a trick. His face kind of looks like just any dude that I would draw, but it's okay. I haven't sat down and spent a ton of time drawing characters in a while. Yeah, dude, thanks. Good luck at work. Nose to the old grinding stone. Haha, oops. Just gotta fill in some. Get some of them shapes filled. Tough. I want to do it on a layer so it's not super permanent, but at the same time, if I do that, it's not easy for me to fill in buckets and stuff. The curse, the digital curse, the blessing, and the curse. Hairstyle. Freaky 80s anime hair. Honestly, it might be better if I do. What would be better if I do? How to do freaky 80s anime hair. To be more similar to my brush size. Oops. View. Man, I wish I was using a nib pen right now. That'd be so nice. Poor little tablet. You're nothing like a quill pen. This is, he doesn't have like the skunk patch here, or the thing in the front. It's just a matter of getting stuff blocked in, and then I can get it looking right. It's like a weird additive subtractive thing. Don't worry, Kevin, I'm not going to mess up your drawing. Keep your pants on. Oh, he doesn't have the skunk patch in the stuff that I'm looking at. No way. This isn't X-Men's Rogue. This is Guts. I mean, do you want him to have a skunky patch of hair? Skunky patch. This is your rodeo, after all. No, white patch. No, white patch. Okay, if you say so. There's no turning back. Every one of these pixels is rendered immediately to a laser disc. I don't have a hard drive. I hope you're happy with what you see. Maybe we're getting the hang of this now. Just got all these cute little islands of light in his hair. I wonder how many kids go to like a hairstylist. Like, can you give me cool anime hair? I just wanted to stick up and stick up and around, like I brought in some pictures and a drawing that I made. Can you do that? Can you style my hair? Like my favorite anime guy. Excuse me. Yay, I'm liking his hair. Looking good. Oh, thanks, guys. Wow. So kind. I feel engaged and instantly validated. It's the power of the internet. Here's 10 weird tricks to engage your viewership. Here's 7 weird tricks. 7 weird Facebook tricks that Mark Zuckerberg does not want you to know. Artist and hairstylist. My mom was a hairstylist. So maybe it runs in the family. I'll give you some cool anime hair. Just you come to me. We'll get you all sorted out. Look at that little fashion plate, Guts. I'm gonna roughen some stuff on an actual separate layer this time because we've got a lot of black robe stuff to negotiate. Actually, there's only two layers. I don't know what I'm talking about. I think just so many folds. Cloak folds. Someday I'll look into the whole royalty-free music on streaming stuff again. I think I just got so annoyed that I just didn't want to look at it at all. I was like, are you telling me I can't listen to the music that I either have like CDs for or MP3s of, and you want me to get a Spotify account? Nope, not gonna happen. If anything, what I'll do is I'll find some stuff. I'll find stuff on Bandcamp or wherever else, and just intentionally purchase it and get my hands on it. Not sure if old dad can get behind Spotify stuff. Music, subscription music. Whoa, seems so crazy. I can't imagine it's that great for the individual music producers, too. I really can't wait to do the shadows on that cannon. That's gonna be sick. It's gonna make me sick. Yeah, I remember doing spot black shadows like this. I guess this is one thing that's really nice about digital, is knowing that if I screw up a fill, I didn't just smear a pen all over the place and pretending that whiteout is gonna look at all decent. Because usually it just kind of turns blue and looks like you made a huge mistake. This is nice though. I always liked doing comic stuff with a ton of black and heavy shadows all over the place. I feel like it's the most fun. I don't know why. I feel like even when I was in school doing graphic design stuff, I was so any logo I did would just be like this like giant black slab with tiny details cut out of it. It's like really not like sustainable or not even like executable in any weird way. But I was just like, yep, that looks great. I might have been a little bit too close to it. Look at that. Look at that heavy slab of black ink. I love it. This is totally gonna get me hired. quite mastered some of the subtleties of form. I think I still do more heavy, loud stuff than I do subtle stuff anyway, so... Just why whisper when you can scream? Shout out loud. What do we got going on? Gatsu. This cloak is doing everything we need it to do. Whoops. There's the gap. Gotta mind the gap. London Underground. Very nice having just an eraser, being able to just erase out your shadows. Oh, so cool. Metal arms. And my foot itches. What am I gonna do? Check. Did I fill it in right? Nope. Whole screen turns black. Oops. Yeah, I don't know, man. We'll see. I'm still good to... I'm gonna keep cooking for a little bit. Oh, I forgot to draw his hand up here. Haha. Happy birthday, Kim. For your birthday, I'm gonna finish Kevin's drawing of guts. That would be awesome. Yeah, if I'm getting quiet, it's just because I'm getting into like inking zone. Inking is one of those weird things where, you know, doing the actual drawing of a piece, I'll like kind of suck at it if I'm tired or fatigued. But when it comes to inking, it's just kind of like, yeah, I'll just keep going. Let me just do a little bit more. I'll keep working on it, sure. And I'll just wind up going, you know, working too long just because. And it's definitely the kind of thing, at least for me, it feels like it occupies a different like mental space. Whoa, and you know, everybody, you know, it's like the oldest thing in the book to like talk shit about inkers versus pencilers or whatever. I mean, and that's, you know, that's just naive. You know, some people can do both, but you're gonna have some of the best work coming out of the people that do one or the other. But it's interesting for sure to see. I mean, the, you know, any book you find on, you know, comic book drawing process, or you look at the actual finished project, you think, oh cool, that's interesting what they did there. But seeing it broken down in inking process books, I feel like those are super illuminating compared to, you know, you always see the how to draw stuff, but just seeing the, you know, the kind of stuff that, you know, some penciler might give to an inker, or even like you think for yourself, all right, if I'm gonna be inking my own work, which I do, I think about how much finish or polish do I really need to put into a pencil for me to be able to interpret it and, you know, essentially do the final pass and render on it. And it's the kind of thing where, especially on paper, I've wound up letting myself, if I know I'm going to be inking something, I'll keep the drawing really loose just because it'll save me a little bit of time, and I can get into inking all that much quicker. And there's a lot of stuff that I'll do kind of on the fly that I didn't set up. You know, I'm not drawing every detail that I'm putting onto the page when I have the pen going, and it's fun. I really like the process. I don't think I'd ever really be interested in inking somebody else's work, but it's something for myself, at least, I enjoy a lot. And also too, I've done you know, some comic book work with other people before. Somebody else writes something, and I trying to give them a hand getting something set up, and the pencils that I would submit, you know, could be a little bit surprising as far as, you know, not necessarily what they would expect. Like, this doesn't look like a finished thing. And I'd say, yeah, hasn't been inked yet, you know? And a little bit of a, you know, you learn how I work, I learn how you work kind of thing. Just the old expectations. got expectations. Nothing like the 11 o'clock burps. Keep you going. Yeah, I started running again. Yesterday and today. I got rained on a lot yesterday. Today wasn't as bad, but it was super cold. Oh my god, it was cold. I was talking to the guy at work who I used to run with, and just like remembering words that I didn't know existed, like balaclava. If I keep running in the winter, I might need to get a balaclava to stick around my face. I'm running from myself. No, I started running this summer, and it was cool because I was, you know, getting some good exercise in and feeling jazzed, and then the weather, winter comes around, and it hasn't even been that cold this winter, but I started thinking, oh gosh, can't run in the winter, it's so cold. And you know, you have like holidays come around, you eat a lot of cookies, you start feeling a little bit ick, and I was just saying to myself, why didn't I just keep like twice a week, just run around for 20 minutes. So trying to get back on that train. I could crochet a balaclava. Yeah, I figure it feels like, at least like trying to run in the winter, it's so much more of a struggle just to like do the ordinary thing. I feel like I'm barely running as far as I used to. Partly because I haven't done it in a couple months, but then also it's just so cold. But I think that might be part of it. You just like run around, struggle, like snot pours out of your face, and you're just trying to hold your face with your gloves. Yeah, running with gloves even, because it's so damn cold. But that's the kind of thing where it's invigorating too. It was fun. So I'll give it the old college try. If I can get 2 solid weeks in, I'm good to continue, and I'll do it through the spring. It's just that I gotta get past that pick it up, put it down point. Kim, I don't want your links. Why are you posting your links in my chat? Can I like hover over this? Reveal this link? Oh, that Cthulhu mask thing. You mean my Zoidberg face that I crocheted? Because I love Zoidberg. Dude, I love your Zoidberg costume. Thanks, I'm a mind flayer. Oh well. I'll just wear the cloak. that was so good. Dude, I love Zoidberg. Awesome. I love Futurama. It was a mind flayer.
Look at that cloak. He just looks like a naked dude without the sketch on underneath. That's funny. Alright, let's get these in. Real rough, can always finesse it. Guts would be a good, cool character to... that Mind Flayer picture. Guts would be a good character to make a D&D dude after. Here we go, I'm gonna share this with the world. I love Mind Flayers. They're so cool. So this is funny. As far as like weird artistic interpretations of what could be considered like Dungeons and Dragons canon or not. So here we've got like a painting. It's a newer painting. It's not classic. It's not like a classic old school D&D thing. But you know, you've got like the Mind Flayer. He's got his noodles wrapped around that guy's face, and he looks like he's definitely like munching on to his head with his beak. If he's got a beak inside of there, like a little squid man. But there's books that they published in second edition or advanced D&D. Specifically this one called The Alithiad, which was all about Mind Flayer, you know, ecology, Mind Flayer physiology, and this and that. And according to The Alithiad, they actually feed through their tentacles. Like, inside of each tentacle, there's like a hollow pipette that, like, runs into whatever thing they subsist, or like, whatever orifice they eat from. And they actually have, like, an enzyme on their tentacles that, like, dissolves flesh and bone, or they do it by like psionic vibration, so you're not going to have like a Mind Flayer squid onto somebody's face. They're actually going to like noodle right into your brain and suck out your brains through the little flesh straws. So that's a little bit of fantasy physiology lesson for you for tonight.
I don't think that representation of a Mind Flayer is canon. I don't know.
Please do. I also wonder how many, like, teeth he rendered that guy's mouth having. Definitely looks like he has, like, 64 teeth on his bottom jaw.
That's crazy. Come on.
Haven't you ever been to a dentist, pal?
Look in a mirror sometime. Count your teeth. Crazy mutant.
Yeah, visit your local library. Don't you know the Dewey Decimal System? Punk, come on. Now you're getting me angry.
Don't you know the Dewey Decimal System?
Freaking UHF. So good. He's got his black pants. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, I can't remember. It's kind of like, I guess it's kind of like the Sisyphus thing. The whole Guts struggling to be more than a human so he can destroy these like pseudo divine demon things. I don't know. I think a lot about that kind of narrative, and also too just like him like refusing to give up. He's like literally dying, but somehow is not dying. He's like surviving still, but he's just like getting
beaten and mashed to a pulp, but just refusing to stop. I don't know. There's something cool about that.
Sissy fits.
Yeah. I like the part in Berserk when Guts has a sissy fit. Because he's a big sissy. No, I'm spelling it out. Oh, I can't even type. Sisyphus. You know, the mythological dude who's like condemned to roll a boulder up a hill for eternity, and then it rolls back down, and then he rolls it back up again, and then it rolls back down. Can't stop. He's like damned to continue. Damned to continue trying, even though he knows he's gonna fail. There's something weirdly universal about that. Even just like, I think about that as far as, you know, doing a creative endeavor and trying to get people to give a damn. It's interesting, you know? It's like you continue. Keep going, you keep going, and it's, you know, people say like, oh, you don't want to give up, you don't want to stop, because you got to see it through, you got to pay your dues, put in the time, this and that. But sometimes, you know, it's like you've got limited time. Can't spend forever working on stuff. Or even just, what is it? I'm trying to think. I'm like getting into like weird garbled mental headspace, but just like stuff that I think about a lot. Or it's like, it's weird equal parts, so. I feel like it resonates with sort of like American rebel spirit DNA I think about a lot, as far as, you know, what would, you know, like an American national identity be if you look at history of all this stuff. Like the path of like the country has been, you know, on for a long time, even maybe in like an ideal fashion, just kind of like imagining sort of, you know, like an American ideal is kind of a fantasy thing, and it's kind of like, you know, doing what you're going to do in spite of like being told not to. Yeah, you know, he honestly is. Blasto saying that Guts is the Japanese James Dean. It's something too, and it's like not fair. It's not fair to, you know, claim it as like an American thing, because it's bigger than that. It's this human struggle of, you know, I should be dead. I should have stopped. I should have quit, but I'm not going to stop, and I'm not going to quit because I'm not done. Or not, whatever, this or that, or the thing that I'm trying to achieve hasn't been achieved. And even then, it's, like, impossible. And it's, you know, in, like, the storytelling sense, it's definitely, you know, beyond real. It's hyper-real. In something like Berserk, where you have this guy who's, like, literally trying to kill demons that are, you know, as good as, you know, like, demigods, as good as gods as far as, like, a mortal is concerned, but somehow he's, like, you know, continuing that struggle. And it's interesting. It's just, like, this weird, like, hyper-real, supernatural unwillingness to stop, even though every, you know, rational authority is saying, stop. You're done. this is, it's over. And there's like this stubborn, scarred up, you know, mutilated, you know, poor bastard who's like, no, I'm not gonna stop. I don't know. It's the kind of thing that I dwell upon in the wee hours of the night. Like this. We're definitely getting into the wee hours. Just sick, sad, unstoppable bastard. That's the point, man. That's the point. I think about this stuff because I'm trying to figure out how I fit into the scheme of things. You know, I can't think of, I mean, I could literally count them, like the number of years, the amount of time that I've been, you know, working on stuff like this. Yeah, this is like self-reflective hour. But, you know, it's like, I think about it sometimes, it's like, isn't it kind of absurd that I'm gonna stay up all night to try and like just like make something? Like, I could be like well rested tomorrow and, you know, maybe more pleasant to be around because I'm not gonna be, you know, tired and cranky and irascible. I hope I don't give people a hard time because I'm overdoing this stuff. But that's the thing though, it's like, if I wasn't working on this, I'd be doing something else. Yeah, the context of, like, right now, this tonight is just one little tiny thing. But it's just kind of thinking about that stuff and the... the grander scheme of things. It's like, I'm just trying to figure out, like, why do I do this stuff? Do I do it for me? Do I do it for this? No, dude! Don't. You're taking this stuff really literal. I'm just musing right now. Yeah. Sorry, Marlene. For my birthday, what I really want is I want to go down to the basement and finish drawing. Guts for Kevin. Ow, my balls. Why did you have to bust my balls? It's a good thing I'm wearing sweatpants. Thank God. Can always count on you for a double sack whack. Yeah, I really want to know. Tell me why. No, Kim, a double sack whack. Did you guys ever see Adventureland? It's a reference to a movie. I can't remember the name of the dude. So I'm just gonna assume that you saw. I'm gonna assume that you didn't. I don't know. You must have seen Adventureland. Jesse Eisenberg. But it's got that dude who always wears like the headband, and he's kind of a pain in the ass. Yeah, he's always like going around and like punching people in the nuts and saying stuff like double sack whack. There, you've seen it once for each sack whack because there's two. You know, that kind of cool teenage emasculating friend who thinks it's cute to like just like smash his friends in the balls. That's what I can always count on Kevin for in the metaphysical sense. Thank you for the metaphysical double sack whack. I think his name is Pete. Oh my God. The mystery is solved. I love that dude. He's like the best thing about that movie.
Oh man, this is getting close to done. I don't know about you,
but we could finish this. Martin Starr is cool. Martin Starr is a cool dude. He's a cool duder. Much respect to Martin Starr. Mysteries. Oh yeah, Kevin, I forgot. I need to look up some cool miniature painting stuff to send you. I know I could find some good ones. I'll send you some cool stuff. Don't worry. Don't worry your pretty little head. Oh, my book back. Oh, the Space Marine Codex. Let's be specific. Yeah, but the visual examples are good. Maybe there weren't so many good ones in that. One, yeah, I wish I had my 40K rule book. Still, that thing must have gone into some mystery garage sale or something. So sorry. A double sack whack again. Oh yeah, have you ever seen the Games Workshop Citadel color line? You should go look at the paint wall at Paradise sometime and see all the colors of the rainbow that they're referring to. It is very specific. It's super specific. But they're all so good. It's like corpse yellow. Oh. Goblin green. Oh yeah. I want to paint stuff with goblin green, even if they're not goblins, but especially goblins. Bleached bone. Oh yeah, give me that color. That sounds like a cool ass color. Millennium. Nice. I haven't been over there in a while. Oh, snap. Yeah, man, they're your neighbors, practically. You gotta go bother them. You gotta go make them real mad by trying to walk through the store. That's the best. Didn't you read the sign? No through traffic. I thought it was a paradise, but it turned into hell. Yeah, man, you can get like chips in there too. Chips and soda and drinks. I came for the game, but I stayed for the chips. Yeah, they've got some funny, silly snacks going on. You know, when you're like deep into a heavy role-playing session, and you get the hungries. You don't want to miss the next thrilling revelation by our dungeon master, so they're there to cater to that need. I'm in the middle of this riveting game. I can't help but need to leave my seat. I don't want to miss what happens next. Those are the best moments. Can't get up and pee. My friend's gonna say some imaginary stuff to me, and it's gonna be awesome. Adventure! Stretchy leather pants. I want to
read all of that thing. I like the Berserk. I want to keep reading it.
Delightfully borrow your copies, or if it gets to be tedious, I'll probably pick them up. Maybe see if I can score them on eBay or something through somebody unloading a bunch of them. It seems like a cool way to do it. Yeah, We'll just keep doing a couple at a time. Seems pretty good.
Poor Borders.
Sorry, Borders. Rest in peace. I'm not sure what, but I want to include like a weird grinning behelit behind him or something. I feel like that could be a nice little design element. That I probably won't do tonight, but probably will be closing out pretty soon, but I'm satisfied with the what we've got down. This is the kind of thing where I'll look at it again tomorrow. I'll be like, oh, cool. I have no idea I put that much work into this so far. Gotcha. Just how that goes. Yeah, I think the biggest thing I was worried about with nasty weather running is I was worried I was going to immediately get horribly sick. But so far not terrible. Stoked to read some more creepy comics magazines from that Warren Publishing archive. There's a lot of really good stuff in there. It's all free too. That's awesome. What does Kevin say? He's the big judge. Oh yeah, I'll pull up that link for you guys. There's so much good stuff on here. A ton of Vampirella stuff. But like the original creepy magazine, creepy comics, this, that, the other thing. It's a trove. Whoa, what is this? Not found. Huh. Your link came through all gobbledy gobbledygooked
Mr. Blasto.
This is too good. Mr. Guts, he's a bellissimo. Molto bene, Guts. Grazie. That's so good. That Guts, he's a spicy meatball. That's amore. Hilarious. Mr. Guts, he's looking for a behelite. A little behelite. It's very little. Maybe you've seen it. It's got eyes on a face. Have you seen a Mr. Guts, a behelite? He's looking for one. Awesome. Damn it, this arm doesn't have all the cool hatching tricks that the other one does. Dun, dun, dun.
Guts. Do you have it? Guts.
Guts.
I bet the shape. Oh. The shape would look nice if it was all hatching. Yeah, dude. Psychotic Tetty 13, please.
I'm not usually drawing
fan art comic stuff. I'm usually doing pixel art or some game thing. I did a little bit of my comics stuff, but yeah. Hang out. I'm usually here Mondays and Tuesdays. Might not be here tomorrow because it's my birthday. So I might be really relaxing. But, you know, most Mondays and Tuesdays. Did I say Tuesdays and Thursdays?
Ah!
That's not the case. I won't stream on a Thursday. That's absurd. You gotta be crazy. Yeah, man, hang out. Following is nice. You can hit me up on Twitter too if you've got any questions or. I think I have it set up that anytime I go live, it will send out a little notification. It's probably pretty rare that I'm going to be doing any streaming off schedule. But, you know, I try to be pretty available on Twitter and stuff, or, you know, hang out and chat, send some messages back and forth. New internet friends. It's pretty nice. I think I've got links for all that below the player, the channel info stuff, so. You know, let's do the internet thing. You know, the internet stuff. Guts. But yeah, psychotic. I just started getting back into the books. I only read the first volume. And Cablasto's letting me borrow all the stuff. Awesome, dude. Thank you. Cablasto's letting me borrow the books, so I'm getting back into it. And my mind's a little bit blown how crazy stuff gets so quickly. And it's super, super good. Good thing. It makes me wish I had been reading it sooner. So I'm actually probably going to wind down by reading some more, just to get my mind all calm. Because I don't know, I love streaming. It gets my, like, after I end a stream, I just feel super excited. Not because it ended, but I'm like, yay, that was fun. Hanging out with friends, doing the internet thing. So it feels like a good thing to do. Yeah, I am gonna start listening to you always, Kablasto. Yeah, this guy's got all the books, so I'm gonna be bugging him. Can I borrow another? I just need one more bump. I just need that guts bump. Yeah. I could probably go a little crazier with the lions. Maybe. Yeah, I'll do a little bit more on this. I'll probably do like any kind of final touches, cleanup, pass off stream. I'd love for there to be another thing or two. I don't know. Might be nice to do like some simple color. I probably honestly would keep it black and white just for the sake of sanity. But this was fun. I haven't sat down and done any tough guy art in a while. I can't poop my pants. I'm busy getting my balls busted. There's a conflict of interest here. I don't know what to do. Black and white. Yeah. That's good, dude. I still prefer black and white comics over color anything. I feel like I've rarely found a comic that I think, God, this couldn't have existed if they just did it in black and white, or black and white and made it just kind of appealing in that regard. But, you know, people don't want to read black and white stuff. It's not the mass market appeal. I always feel like this kind of stuff looks like weird bacon after a while, just drawing like marbled pork. And the finishing touch. Whoops. Yeah, I'm fumbling this hard. I just need a tiny little puck. Let's get him to scale. Oh, Mr. Guts. It's cute.
Oh, I mean, there's some... Holy crap, you ordered.
There's some really good, you know, color comics out there. Who's it? Is it Dave Stewart, the guy that does all the like the Hellboy coloring? I can't remember that guy's name, but his stuff. If somebody's gonna color a comic, I want it to look like that. That's nice. But I don't really read a lot of comics anyway, so I'm not really a good judge. Dave Stewart's a good dude. Oh, Jesus, I forgot his hand. Let me just do this. I, like, talked about the hand 3 times. Check that out. Whistling time. This plunge probably needs a little bit of Slurpee Frog. Slurpee Fog. I wonder if I know this is funny too, because I know that my tablet is mapped to the whole width of both monitors, but I feel like the results have been okay. I haven't, like, run into some sort of moment while working on this where I'm thinking, oh my god, I wish my tablet was only mapped to the left side or the right side. I feel like that's kind of strange. I feel like I should have reacted badly to it. I don't know. Well, maybe I'll understand it someday. Spaghetti. Spaghetti hot. Huh? Like a big pizza. Orders up. My cannon's full of soup. Who wants a drink? Heh heh.
you have the guts to eat my spicy meatball?
That's screwed up. Berserk. The helot pendant. It's so weird the how like freaking tranquil the like the dormant Behelit is, and then it just turns into this like visceral crying bloody thing. It's so foreboding. I'm like terrified to read more. I just can't wait to see how insane stuff gets. Black out his eye a little bit more.
The Behelit balls.
Give him a little more raccoon eyes. I'm surprised I'm not chilly in the basement myself. It's kind of comfortable down here. These birthday sweatpants are the best. I love it. I wish I could get sweatpants for every birthday. Alright, I think that's all for tonight, folks. This has been rad. We got some cool work done. Drew some tough guy art. Talked about Berserk. Got me pumped to read some more comics. Yeah. It's late. I feel dazzled and dazed. Glad you like it, dude. This is how it's done, I suppose. Pray Cabbage, thanks, man. Let me do a little preview thing here. Talk about Halloween for a quick minute. Turn the music off. So mostly I do art on games. I work for a company called Working Man Interactive, and where is it? Let me actually just pop up my hang on a second. Let me fumble with the internet real quick. Talk about Death State game for a quick second. Just go to the Steam page. Hang on. So Death State is a very fun project that I had the good fortune to co-create at Working Man. It's on Steam now. Whoa, look at that. Look at that sick trailer. I hope this doesn't, I'm not going to play that because I don't want it to tank out the stream. But it's a roguelike bullet hell single stick shooter. Has a lot of weird Lovecraftian stuff going on in it. Oh, I'm no longer a disembodied floating head. What happened? Hang on a second. I think I'm still there. I'm a disembodied floating head in front of a web browser. Death State, we made this, a lot of people helped and worked on it, but I created the game with Matt Leffler, solid dude. We've been updating it since launch in October. Bottom right, yeah, I understand, Kim, I get it, I'm down to the bottom now. I like it down here, it's fun. But yeah, I think we still have a couple more things to add to the game. I feel like it's mostly content complete, but we'll be adding some whatever we can find that we can add that is, I guess, achievable within a certain like abstract time frame, and adds a lot to the game. There's like a weird Venn diagram space that exists in. We'll try to do that, and you can check it out if you want. It's a fun game. There's been a lot of people streaming it on Twitch lately, and you know, doing some YouTube coverage and things. So if you're checking out the trailer and you want to know more about what the game is, psychotic. Thanks, man. There's a lot of media out there happening. A lot of it is, you know, pretty well balanced. People are talking about what they like, what they dislike. It's getting a lot of conversation going. You know, if you pick up the game, if you enjoy it, if you want to leave a review on Steam, that's always really beneficial. And again, too, you know, the positive reviews help out a lot. But also, too, we've been trying to take a look at the negative reviews and critique that people have been leaving. And if it's something that we can address with some game changes and tweaks that don't compromise the design overall, we want to do that stuff too. So people have been pretty good and measured about giving real feedback. Let's see. So like I said, I'm trying to stream Mondays and Tuesday nights most weeks. If you want to check out more of my stuff, I have a website, imaginarymonsters.com. Yeah, I'm very happy with the game. It's the kind of thing where, you know, I've been making stuff for so long, and I know that I like what I make, and I wouldn't be making the things that I make if I didn't like them myself. And it's just like every now and then you get a chance to like make something and see how much that other people begin to appreciate it too, and it's good, it's validating, but also too, it's like, I don't know, I was kind of like rambling about some weird philosophical stuff earlier on, but you know, you wonder like why you make things, like why you continue to make stuff. And part of it is just because, you know, it's like Death State exists because, you know, Matt and I had spare time at work to do something like this, and we didn't put it down like during downtime, and we got to a point where we could actually say, all right, this exists in some form, we're actually going to, you know, produce it in a way. But there's, if you want to look at some other cool stuff, read some cool stuff, I've been kind of talking about some game process on my website, and I gave like a little presentation the other week and talked about that, just as far as, you know, there's a bunch of weird stuff. There's a lot of comics too. I started imaginarymonsters.com as a webcomic site years ago, and have like picked it up and put it down since then, and like taken extended hiatuses, but it's just kind of the place to go and look to see, you know, what I'm working on. But I just did a Halloween Forever comic, which was nice. It's short, like 8 pages, but Halloween Forever, this is something that I made from scratch. I didn't make the music. That was done by Robert Mostyn, and there's a link to his page on the itch page, but he's a really good chiptune composer, other music composer, and he's doing some game dev stuff now himself too, which is super nice to see. But I wanted to learn how to program games as well as just do the art for them, so I made Halloween Forever. It took me about a year to, like, you know, take breaks and learn Game Maker and, you know, work on it actively, not work on it for a while, be a dad, that kind of thing, go to work, be a decent husband. So it's definitely a product of, you know, trying to balance life and not sacrifice too many of like the good things that you want to keep while working on a project like this. But it's been fun to do. I'm in the process of getting it up onto Steam. It's already been greenlit. I just need to get it submitted and built properly, then I can actually launch it, and then I'll probably start an early access for it while I work on some improvements and additional content. So, but yeah, that's, you know, a couple spiels. If you wanted to check out a fun retro platformer, there's a short game. It's not going to take up a whole lot of your time to play. Easy in, easy out, where you play as a pumpkin man who vomits candy corn. Halloween Forever is a game for you. You check that out. But I've been talking too much. My voice is starting to go. And, yeah. Well, yeah, Psychotic, if you get a chance to check it out, let me know what you think. I mean, the whole me doing streaming stuff on Twitch is very new, too, for me. You know, and meeting people like you in, like, creative and the game dev channel. Grizzle Dude Easter Egg. I'm trying to think if I already have one. Is there a Grizzle Dude appearance? I don't think Grizzle Dude appears anywhere, but, yeah. Unless you count, like, one of these little dead things in the catacomb. One of those can potentially be Grizzle Dude. Yeah, it's the kind of thing. I'm glad I'm getting a chance or taking a chance to go back and add some more stuff to Halloween Forever, as long as I can get the dang thing published to Steam. Because there are a lot of things I want to, you know, add in there and hide on top of what's already kind of in there as secrets and stuff. So, yeah, you know, it's not a super complex game. You could race through it in a couple minutes if you're not trying to go for any secrets or anything, and if you're just like damage boosting through enemies. So, but I learned a lot, and I hope that the next thing I do will be at least as good as Halloween Forever, and then better. So, I'm excited to get to that place too. So, anyway, thank you guys for hanging out. I'm gonna switch. I'm gonna press my little burp keystroke back to our title slate. You're all awesome. This has been fun. I like Twitch. I like hanging out on the internet. I like doing the internet thing with you guys. Happy birthday, Kablasto, 2 days after the fact. And yeah, thank you guys. Psychotic Prey Cabbage, nice meeting you folks. Spaghetti. It's a spaghetti night. Peace out, guys.